Welcome to another video, another learning process. Sorry, another learning session. Now we are going to learn saprotrophic nutrition from chapter 1. So today I am teaching you, or we are learning from chapter 1. The previous video you have seen. The insectivorous plant. Now it is saprotrophic nutrition. Saprotrophic nutrition is the mode of nutrition in which organism feed on dead and decaying matter. Here you can see two examples. What is this? You know, these are mushrooms. Mushroom. Here you can see in the soil how mushroom is grow, and you have already seen mushrooms. Here it is bread, sada hua bread, means decayed bread. How the bread is decayed, you know, a fungus is grown in the bread. Fungus grown in the bread and the bread became spoiled. The bread spoiled. The fungus grow in bread, so that fungus is called a bread mold. Such fungus which grow in bread is called a bread mold. Now this text is given here to read. You read this text given here. You might have seen packets of mushrooms. This is a packet of mushroom that you buy from the shop, sold in the vegetable market. You may have also seen fluffy umbrella like patches growing on rotting wood during the rainy season. You may have seen on rotten wood or rotting wood the mushrooms are grown. These mushrooms are saprotrophs. Why are they growing rotting wood? Because their food is dead and decaying matter. Rotting wood means decaying wood. So mushrooms grow in decaying matter, like all other fungus. Fungus grow in decaying matter. That is why they are saprotroph. So these organisms which grow in dead and decaying matter are called fungi. Here you can see cotton-like outgrowth. Cottony outgrowth it is. Not in color but in texture. So this organism, they have different mode of nutrition. This is bread mold, this is mushroom, two different type of fungus. So these fungus absorb nutrients from the decayed matter. So bread is decayed here and fungus absorb nutrition from the spoiled bread. This mode of nutrition in which organism take in nutrients in solution form from dead and decaying matter is called saprotrophic nutrition. The plants which use saprotrophic mode of nutrition are called saprotroph. And finally we can say saprotrophs are plants or organisms that feed on dead and decaying matter. Okay. So this is about saprotrophic nutrition. Saprotrophic nutrition is also, I told you, I explained you, but these pictures could not show. That is why now I put this video and put this picture here. So now in another video, in another slide, you can see now some home assignments are given here. Define the given keywords. Autotrophic, chlorophyll, heterotroph, host, insectivorous, nutrient, nutrition, parasite, photosynthesis, saprotroph, saprotrophic, stomata. This can be repeated somewhere else. If it is repeated here, in some other questionnaire, if you get the same question to define, you can see once again, if you write once again, there is no problem. So you can write if any definition, if any word you did not define, you can define it now. So it is better that you write all these words, define all these words, understand all these words, and learn them. So here is another question answer session. Define the following: photosynthesis, saprotrophic mode of nutrition, parasite. I think these three were in the previous one. See, there is photosynthesis, there is parasite, and photosynthesis here, parasite is here, saprotrophic is here. Here, so all the three are given here again. So you write once, no need to repeat. These are important, that is why it is repeatedly asking. Now give reason. There are three question answers I have given you. Give reason. I have given the answers also, because they are important questions. You have to know. There are some more questions in your book, but I select only three now. Mushroom is a saprotroph because mushroom feed on dead and decaying matter. Very, very simple way I have given the answers to you in very short form, not elaborately. So mushroom is a saprotroph. Why? Give reason. Because mushroom feed on dead and decaying matter. Second, leaf is known as the food factory of the plant. So tell me, why leaf is known as the food factory of the plant? Because the food factory is where the food is produced. Where the food is produced in plant? Leaf. So leaf contains chlorophyll. In this chlorophyll, food is prepared. So leaf is called the food factory of the plant. Leaf contains chlorophyll. In this chlorophyll, photosynthesis takes place. Photosynthesis is the process of preparing food. Okay. Now lichen is a living partnership between a fungus and an alga, and this partnership is beneficial to both. Why? Because in lichen, the fungus provides shelter for the alga and the alga prepare food for the fungus. That is why they are a living partnership. Both are beneficial to each other. Okay, so learn these answers. Very simple. The science in 7 is very simple, but you should know that it is the basic of further science learning. So in 8, 9, 10, for learning science, advanced science, science and technology, this is your basic class. So here if you do well, if you learn all the things, then it will be very good for you for further studies in secondary level. So you have to work hard, otherwise you could not understand much in higher classes. So work hard in science. This is a very interesting topic. Do experiments by your own. Be safe by staying at home, and make your time or use your time in a better, efficient and positive way. Okay? Bye. Thank you.